Thank you, Chairman O'Toole. Thank you for your leadership at the Port Authority. Governor Murphy, it's great to have a governor who is an advocate of the transportation infrastructure dollars that we need at the state, and to have a partner at the state so that we can maximize our federal efforts as the senior Democrat on the Mass Transit Subcommittee in the Senate, Congressman Series on the Transportation Infrastructure Committee. Having a partner who works with us in tandem is critically important. So, Governor, thank you for your vision and your advocacy. We appreciate Director Cotton and his work with all of those at the Port Authority. To my colleague, Congressman Sears, who's a tremendous ally in our efforts on the House side in his position there, as well as Mayor Davis. It's fitting and appropriate that we're celebrating this on the 150th anniversary of the great town of Bayonne. And so it's another jewel in that coronation. And to Senator Cunningham and Assemblyman Chevrolati, who are at the state level equally powerful advocates. We're here today because this project was about more than raising the Bayonne Bridge. It was about raising economic prospects for our state and for our region. It was about securing the Port of New York and New Jersey as the megaport of the East Coast, as the gateway for global commerce and jobs in the 21st century. I've been fighting to modernize our port for over three decades now. When I first had the privilege of getting elected as a congressman, my district at that time was the 13th district, and it included the entire port region. And like most New Jerseyans, I looked out there and I saw cranes, and I knew something was going on out there, but I never came to understand until I became the congressman about the enormous economic impact, 20-some-odd billion dollars of economic activity, over a quarter of a million jobs related to the port activity. And at that time, we had 5 years of backlog permits. We were losing shipping to Halifax, Canada, and Norfolk, Virginia, because we couldn't get dredging done. And I went to work, and we cleared up 5 years of backlog permits, ended up having then Al Gore, who was the head of the Environmental Quality Council under the Clinton administration, help us end the dumping of the sediments that were contaminated out in the mud dump, use them for beneficial reuse. So IKEA and all of that section of the port region was developed on sediments that were reclaimed at the end of the day and cleaned up. And we went to the largest channel deepening project in the history of the United States. And that's why the Bayonne Bridge had to be raised. And that's what we're celebrating today. So we've been working for some time to be able to make sure that we continue to be the most significant leader in the movement of goods throughout our region and the world. When we came to the Senate, I worked to secure over $880 million in federal funding to deepen the harbor to 50 feet so we could serve the larger vessels coming to the widened Panama Canal. Yet dredging the harbor wasn't enough because larger cargo ships still meant the challenge of clearing the Bayonne Bridge. So when local officials devised the Raise the Roadway initiative, our delegation went to work and convinced then President Obama to give the project expedited status. Deepening the harbor, expanding our capacity, raising the Bayonne Bridge took years of cooperation at the local, state, and federal level, and our efforts are paying off. Since lifting the span to 215 feet, record numbers of larger vessels have come to call at our port. And beyond generating billions in business revenue, the port supports good-paying jobs for thousands of longshoremen, Teamsters, and others, who in 2018 helped move an unprecedented 7 million port containers. For nearly a century, the iconic steel arches of the Bayonne Bridge have spanned the Kilvan Cove. Today marks a new chapter in its history, not just as a bridge between two states, but as a bridge to greater opportunities for the people of New Jersey and beyond. It's my hope that every vessel that passes beneath this bridge reminds us that when we invest in our infrastructure, we build a stronger economy for all of us. And today, we can say with pride that the Port of New York and New Jersey will be open for business for decades to come. Congratulations to everybody involved, and thank you so much, Barry.